Hey, everybody, this is Vince Miller. Thank you so much for joining me for another devotional. Today, we're going to be in John chapter 6. I'm going to read verses 52 through 59. Before I do, a little shout out today to Scott Besser from Lakeville, Minnesota. Brother, thank you for sharing these devotionals with your friend who recently came to the end of his life. What an honor to be a part of the last moments of his life when he moved from the land of the dying into the land of the living. Thanks for doing that, man. This is for you today. The text reads, "The Jews then disputed among themselves about some of the things Jesus was teaching. How can this man give us his flesh to eat? So Jesus said to them, 'Truly, truly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you.'" And remember, these are metonyms here. "Whoever feeds on my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever feeds on my flesh and drinks on my blood abides in me, and I in him. As the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, whosoever feeds on me, he will also live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like the bread the fathers ate and died." So he's making a very clear point. He's differentiating the metonyms, right? "Whoever feeds on this bread, him, will live forever." Jesus said these things in the synagogue as he taught at Capernaum. So I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not sure how this moment didn't result in a riot for Jesus. I mean, this is some pretty strong stuff here. And for those of you just jumping in with me on this Daily Devo, this might be a little bit of a weird text if you haven't read the last few days of devotionals, so I would encourage you to go back and to read those so you understand what Jesus is talking about here. Just to be clear, Jesus is not asking us to eat his flesh and drink his blood. The words flesh and blood are metonymies or metonyms, which are stand-in words referring to spiritual sustenance. We learn here that his spiritual sustenance is provided by Jesus and in Jesus. This means that he's the one bringing the spiritual sustenance down into the world, and he is the spiritual sustenance that we need. He's both the messenger of life and the life. So what Jesus is telling them is, if they want real and lasting sustenance, satisfaction, it's found in something other than food and drink. Because food and drink are temporary. Jesus even points to the manna that God gave the people in the desert who are now dead. His point is that natural provision is going to do nothing for them. So him making more bread for another 5,000 ain't going to do much. This means that Jesus is trying to give them the very best sustenance, something that really satisfies. They don't entirely see it, but he's trying to give them a better meal, a more satisfying meal. And the way you consume this meal is not with your mouth. It's with your heart and your mind and your soul. And this is not a one-time passing belief in Jesus. It's not like a snack that you have once in a while. This is not casual belief that's only exhibited on Sunday mornings. This is not belief only in a Savior who saves, but a Lord who leads your life for the rest of your life. This is an all-the-time, all-consuming meal that we enjoy in full belief, regardless of the circumstances that ever come our way. It satisfies us when we're hungry. It satisfies us when we lose our jobs. It satisfies when our marriage is falling apart. It satisfies us when we're facing a life-threatening illness. It satisfies us when we are down and out and no one else is around. It is a consuming belief in Jesus who completely satisfies our souls. So the question is, do you want this meal? And the answer is, then consume Jesus and let him consume you. I love you guys. I pray this has blessed you today. If it has, share it with someone else, and I'll see you right back here again.